Talks about his Busch Series debut. Steve Mills shows us how to get a wrecked race car race ready. And the latest from Formula One. But first, two of the big-name drivers in Saturday's Busch Series race in Charlotte crashed with less than 20 minutes left in final practice on Friday. Both Jeff Green, who qualified fifth, and Jeff Purvis, who had qualified 15th, will have to go to backup cars and start now at the end of the field.
You're going so fast in these corners here, you know, it's just if anything, little thing happens. It's unreal, and I guess I run over something, cut a right front, and it was nothing but hold on and see stars from then. But they got us another backup car here, and I guarantee we'll be just as good as that one, and looking forward to tomorrow. Hopefully I'm not too sore.
I just hate it. We really had high hopes for that car. We just knew that car would come up here and win this race, and you know, I'm not giving up on this car yet. They're going to go over there and put the same setup under it that we were running and put the things that we'd learned off the other car, and, you know, we'll just have to come back tomorrow and get after them, but... Just a bad situation right there. I should have parked it about 10 laps ago.
31 drivers started Friday's 40-lap challenge race at Charlotte, eyeing a spot in Saturday's big show. Larry Pearson was guaranteed a position as a former series champion. That left only 10 starting positions up for grabs. And Dave Marcus, starting from the outside of the front row, gets the jump on pole sitter Ron Barfield. And then, look at this, second lap, Rodney Combs crashed into Elliott Sadler, and 12 cars wind up getting tangled up. Look at that mess coming out of turn number two. In fact, Dennis Setzer's 77 car caught on fire, but Dennis was okay. A few laps after that, number 55, Kevin Simmons, smacks the wall in one and two. 19 laps in, it was Danny Edwards' turn to hit the wall in the 61 car. Well, Marcus led every lap, went on to take the victory. He dedicated the race afterwards to the late Harry Hyde and Ivan Baldwin. Marcus picks up a check for $500 for the win, but the important thing is, he makes Saturday's Busch Series race, as do Jimmy Spencer, Kyle Petty, and Tommy Houston. For Marcus, his first trip to victory lane since 1982.
We've practiced with some of the good cars. I mean, that you know, Mark Martin runs awfully well here, and Trickle's running well, and David Green's running well, and Randy LaJoy's running well. I mean, there's a lot of good cars that are running well, and we still got to beat them too tomorrow. So, I mean, it's not as easy as it looks. Today, it will not be that easy tomorrow, I can assure you.
Didn't qualify yesterday, driver had brain fade. We probably had one of the top five cars here, and I went through one and two so well, I thought I could really go through three and four, and obviously I didn't, so I ended up having to run this race, but it was good. We had a good, clean race, and, you know, Dave won, and I asked him, I said, you're teaching these high school boys how to run again, ain't you, man? So congratulations to him, but it was good, and this gets us in the race.
We were racing hard. It was a heck of a race. Everybody raced clean, though, you know, and unfortunately, at the beginning of the race, there were a lot of guys got tore up, and we didn't want that to happen to us. We wanted to earn it.
We fought a tight race car all weekend, and we thought this morning we had it loosened up, you know, and the first race, it was really good there, and about halfway, it got to where it went back to pushing again. I don't know if the sun or just warmed up and changed their track that much, or if I just told them it's set up that much, but we've been well since we've been here, and we just done all we could do.
Tim Vito will finish sixth. He transfers to the big show. Mike Wallace, eighth, followed by Jeremy Mayfield and Jim Bound. As you check out some of the big names not making Saturday's race, the last four drivers all were taken out in that second lap crash. Of course, the Winston Cup teams had the day off at the track, so the news focused on the Busch Series. Headlining the activity, the announcement that Clyde Booth was leaving Joe Nemechek's team to become director of Winston Cup operations for Chad Little and team owner Mark Rippon. Bill Weber has the rest of the day's news.
They wondered if anybody'd be here on Friday since there wasn't a lot going on. I told them as long as they served lunch, you guys would show up. So. Once again, I was right. You're too easy to read sometimes.
Hey, but that's not the only reason we were here today. All the good tee times were taken, too. But really, it was a busy day here at the Charlotte Motor Speedway, kicked off by Dale Jarrett's announcement of a new sponsor for his Busch team for the next 2 years, White Rain. It's an aggressive 14-race schedule that could lead to the eventual expansion of DAJ racing.
Down the road, we certainly are looking at a Winston Cup team. Whether I'm the driver or not, I don't know, but I want to have a Winston Cup team. I'm not going to drive forever, and I don't want to have to get a real job, so I'm going to try to own a team.
The Band-Aid sponsorship is expected to move to Michael Waltrip's Busch car for next season. An announcement is scheduled for Saturday. Base Motorsports won the 1995 Busch Series Championship with Johnny Benson. This season, they've won five races with Randy LaJoy and are second to David Green in points. Next season, Base will become a two-car team, with series veteran Tim Fitowa joining the organization. Kleenex will be the sponsor. Both cars will be Chevrolets.
They're knocking on number two, and so that, you know, that makes me feel good going to a good team, but it also puts a lot of pressure on me and my ability, but I have confidence in myself, and I think, you know, with a little bit of luck, we can go a long way.
We've got four or five guys on our team, on the 74 FINA team. They're all former crew chiefs. There's that much talent. If you don't offer those jobs, opportunities for advancement to those guys, then other people out here are going to snatch them away from you after they've been with us a year.
Now, another big announcement is scheduled for Charlotte Motor Speedway on Sunday morning. It's expected to be a new team with strong support from Hendrick Motorsports, sponsorship from M&M Mars, and the driver, more than likely, will be Derek Coe. John?
Thank you, Bill. Damon Hill now has a teammate for next season.